Intretrieval. As the Laplace transform is a linear transformation, during the transformation, int, the information is not lost and then the interference pattern can be studied in the time domain and on the complex S-plane. In section 2, it was explained the transformation int, and their poles and zeros were graphed over the pole zero map. In addition, we developed interference pattern on the frequency plane, being possible to implement the plot. Following, we recover the time function from the complex function int. This section is didactic since the objective is to verify that the complex function's information can also be represented in the time domain. To recover the time function, we calculate the inverse Laplace transform through. The integral complex is in the S-plane, their limits are gamma minus it and gamma plus it, the symbol L minus 1 middle dot equals 12 pi ilint gamma minus it gamma plus it middle dot S that indicates the inverse Laplace transform. Substituting, 21, into, 33, the normalized interference pattern can be obtained by applying the partial fraction, 34, can be expressed as here, A, B, and care constants. To calculate the constant, we use next equality. Using 36, we obtain the next equation system and their solutions as substituting all constants into 37, the time function will be applying table 1, the solved inverse Laplace transform is fundamental Laplace transform. Note, it is the Heaviside function. Observing both 13 and 39, we recover the time function from the complex function. Thus, we confirm that the complex S-plane permits us to study the interferometer system through the complex S-plane, using the pole zero map and bow diagrams. Numerical results and discussion. To verify our proposal, we consider the next interference pattern. From 40, the enveloped finv is a Gaussian function finv equals 2o equals 2 at 2 and the modulate function is fmod equals 1 plus cos 10t, where the angular frequency is omega m equals 10 radians. If the interference pattern is normalized as 12, we obtain shows the interference pattern and the modulate function. A. The simulated interference pattern. B. The modulate function. Calculating the Laplace transform. Using expressions 24 and 42, the zeros are localized at the points. Now, using eqs 26 and 42, the poles are. Finally, its pole zero map can observe in pole zero plot determined from the complex modulate function 42. As seen in the zeros S1 and S2 and the poles S2 and S3 are over the imaginary axis. Their positions depend on the angular frequency, and therefore, their positions change due to the variations of the optical path difference. The pole S1 is over the origin of the complex S-plane, and it was generated by the direct component of our interference pattern. To generate the bow diagram, we consider the next complex function. Combining eqs 28 and 45, the magnitude, in decibels, is where S equals I omega was used. Applying the logarithm rules, the magnitude can calculate as. Using the scientific MATLAB software, we represent its bow plot, see. Bow diagram obtained from the interference pattern. Observing, the magnitude has a small variation between the intervals of 100 to 100.7 and from 101 to 102 while the phase is minus 900. These results confirm the integrative action indicated by 47. The interferometric system produces two asymptotics for the magnitude. First asymptotic is negative, its location is at the point 100.7 and the phase has transitioned from minus 90 to 900. Second asymptotic is positive, its location is 101 and the phase has transitioned from 900 to minus 90. Last interval is between 100.7 and 101. In this case, the magnitude has small variation again but the phase is constant to 90. These results confirm that the interferometer system will have integrative action and derivative action. Here, a complex function was obtained from the interference pattern produced by a coherence interferometer. Considering the pole zero map, poles and zeros depend directly on the optical path difference of an interferometer. The interference pattern generates three poles and two zeros. A pole is over the origin and two poles are over the points plus or minus C omega m. The zeros are over the points plus or minus C omega m2. Now, considering the Bode plot, the interferometer can act as an integrator and as a derivator since the phase can take the value of minus 90O or 90O, C. Both graphical representations permit to know the optical path difference through the angular frequency and its dynamic response. From our analysis and results, it is possible to infer a few key points of our novel method. The complex S-plane permits us to study the interferometric systems. The interference pattern can represent as a complex function whose poles are 3 and zeros are 2. Pole 0 map gives information about the optical path difference. The pole S1 is over the origin and it was generated by the direct component of the interference pattern. S2 and S3 poles are over the imaginary axis and their position are plus or minus C omega m, where omega m is the angular frequency. S1 and S2 zeros are over the imaginary axis and their locations depend on the angular frequency, C. Bode diagram gives us information about the dynamic response of any interference pattern. Based on the Bode diagram, phase information, the interferometer can act as an integrative action and as a derivative action. The complex S-plane permits us to study the interferometric systems. The interference pattern can represent as a complex function whose poles are 3 and zeros are 2. Pole 0 map gives information about the optical path difference. The pole S1 is over the origin and it was generated by the direct component of the interference pattern. S2 and S3 poles are over the imaginary axis and their position are plus or minus C omega m, where omega m is the angular frequency. S1 and S2 zeros are over the imaginary axis and their locations depend on the angular frequency, C. Bode diagram gives us information about the dynamic response of any interference pattern. Based on the Bode diagram, phase information, the interferometer can act as an integrative action and as a derivative action. Based on our results, the interference pattern can be studied by both graphical methods. Those graphical representations can be applied to low-coherence interferometric systems, optical fiber sensors, communication systems, and optical source characterization.